announcement right here. We're thrilled to announce that we're expanding the world of Return of Reckoning with custom voice lines to immerse players even deeper into the old world. See? I could do this shit, man. And calling all talented voice actors. I'm thinking about applying. Like I said, you know, they could have an NPC in the Chaos Waste. Hello, adventurer. And welcome to the Umber Chaotica. All of my Caco demons have run amok. I will reward... I will reward you handsomely if you can help me find them. You know? And, then the Doom music starts playing, because, of course, Caco demons are a thing from Doom.
Yeah, I think that would be a good role for, you know, Samuel L. Jackson, right? That'd be a good role. He could do another speech. You read the Bible, Sigmar. There's this passage I got memorized for just such occasions. Sigmar chapter 12, verse 9 through 15. And the path of the black swordsman is beset on all sides by the tyranny of the high elf and the evil of the mountain dwarves. Blessed is he who shepherds the weak through the valley of darkness. Oh, man. Shadow Warrior can play the Gimp, that's right. Shadow Warrior can play the Gimp. Alright. I've got an ending for it. I don't know how far I should go with this, because, I mean, I'm just joking, right? It's just a joke, but you never know what's going to offend people anymore. But... And I will strike down upon thee with my big-ass black sword. With terrible vengeance, those who choose to oppress and annoy my brothers. And you will know my name is the Black Swordsman when I cut your fracking head off. There, that's... I should put that in the next video, man. I should put that in my next video. Come on, get up. Here we go. I got my ass kicked yesterday.
How dare you?
I didn't know what to do.
This is all wrong.
I looked over at my woman. She said, buddy, I kick it too.
You have stolen my dreams.
I got them low-down, ass-kicking blues. Cause even my baby won't give me no slack.
Yeah, no shit, Sherlock!
All she'll do is give me some smack. Oh man. Life is hard when you got the Warhammer blues. Life is hard when you got them Warhammer blues. Cause nobody will cut you any slack. Yeah, here come my baby again. Gonna whomp me upside the head. And I don't even know what I did. Except not come to bed. But you know, the bed is still there. She could just go to sleep, you know what I'm saying? I mean, you know, I got important stuff to do. I gotta play this game. And nobody understands that we all got the Warhammer blues.
I once dated a woman who was a professional Christopher Walken impersonator. And the only bad part of that was she had a problem. At the end of each night, she had a problem coming out of the role. And so I'd pick her up for dinner. And I'd say, okay, you know, where you want to go? And she sat there and she said, well, you know,
I'm in the mood for tacos and so you know, we go out to eat, and one night she invited me over to dinner to her house. She invited me to her home to dinner to meet the parents, right? That whole bit. And turns out that her parents, both of her parents, were retired Arnold Schwarzenegger impersonators. And so I go over and I knock on the front door, and from the other side of the front door I hear a voice that says, "Come on, open the door, there's a bomb in there." So I open the door and walk in, and both her mother and her father both look up. They both stand up, excuse me. They both stood up and they looked at me and they said, "Sarah Carter?" I said, no. And then my date said, "Don't mind them, they're weird." So her mother was in the kitchen cooking, you know. And just to make conversation, I said, "That smells good. What are we having for dinner?" She looked at me and she said, "It's not a tumor." And so the whole evening was like that, right? You know, the whole evening was like that. And so when it was finally over, and I was going to go home, I went to the door, and I was just about to go out the door. And so I turned and looked at all of them, and I said, "I'll be back." You know? Humor. It is a difficult concept. It is not logical. So off we go. Here is our first caller over to line one, and Biff from London. You are on the air.
Yes. I would much prefer to hear the song you believe to be the best from that English fellow, Billy Idol.
Okay, Biff, you got it. On line two, and Meredith.
Yeah, I want Billy Idol.
We already got Billy Idol. Meredith, pick someone else.
Okay.
Line closed. Over to Paul Muad'Dib calling from Arrakis.
Yes, I demand the Rolling Stones or I will shut down Spice production for a year.
Okay, the Rolling Stones it is. On to George Thorogood calling from Seattle.
Yeah, I want to hear George Thorogood.
Wait, is this actually the George Thorogood?
No.
Okay, on the line seven, and Buster.
Hey, this is Buster from Houston. You want to know my last name?
No, not really. What is your selection?
Yeah, okay, Pink Floyd. And remember, my name is Buster, and my last name is...
Line closed on the line eight, and someone calling from Washington, D.C. named Alexandria.
The world is going to end in 12 years if we don't address climate change. And your biggest issue is, how are we going to pay for it?
No, my question was, what artist or group do you want to hear the best song from?
Look at that big ass. Look at that big juicy booty.
Of course. We'll just play Queen and call it even. On to Bob in Cincinnati.
Yeah, this is Bob in Cincinnati.
Go ahead, Bob.
Go ahead with what?
What artist do you want to hear from?
Artist? Vincent Van Gogh.
No, I mean musical artist, Bob.
This is Bob in Cincinnati.
Yeah, Bob, go ahead. You're on the air.
What's that girl's name? Blink? Blink 8675309?
You mean Blink 182?
Yeah, those guys.
Well, okay. You did get through on the phone, so Blink 182 it is. On to Monica in Washington, D.C.
Hi, I'm Monica. I want to hear the best song by ZZ Top.
Wow, Monica, you have a really deep voice.
Yeah, well, my throat's been really banged up ever since the 1990s.
Let's go to Mysterious somewhere in PA.
Yeah, play the best song by Frankie Goes to Hollywood.
But Mysterious, Frankie Goes to Hollywood only did one song.
Homophobe!
Okay, on to Debbie in Dallas.
Blondie, I think, yes, Blondie. I think Blondie, yes.
This isn't a trick question, Debbie. Okay, on to Dave in Chattanooga. Go ahead, Dave.
Dave? Dave's not here, man.
Okay, on to Al in Hollywood. Play the Romantics, that song by the Romantics. You mean What I Like About You?
Yeah, that one.
You just want to see the post-apocalyptic dancing girls, right, Al?
Yeah.
And finally, we have Mata Masayuki Moho Shomi-chan calling from Japan.
Great Jones-chan.
Okay, time for two more. Let's go to line four, and Greta.
How dare you?
Over to Line 5 and Spencer from Oakland. You should play something by the Spencer Davis Group. How do you guys keep getting this line?
Just play it, man. No one else will.
Yep, fat check true. Okay, over to Line 7 and Randy in Cleveland.
Hi, it's Randy.
Yes, hello, you are on the air.
Play something by the Beatles, baby, just for Randy.
Why do you keep saying your name like that?
Because Randy.
Okay, the Beatles it is. Okay, sports fans, our song list is complete. So in no particular order, please enjoy our selections for the best song done by each of the artists or groups as dictated by you, our valued listeners. This is the WKRP Open Line Request Hour.
You want answers? I think I'm entitled. You want answers? I want the truth. You can't handle the truth. Son, we play a game which has Discord, and somebody has to monitor that Discord. And who's gonna do it? You? You, Witch Hunter Weinberg? I have a greater responsibility than you can possibly fathom. You weep for Gobo Club, and you curse Return of Reckoning. You have that luxury. You have the luxury of not knowing what I know. That Gobo Club's paranoia, while tragic, probably saved lives. And my existence, while grotesque and incomprehensible to you, saves lives. You don't want the truth because deep down in places you don't talk about while gaming, you want me in that Discord. You need me in that Discord. We use words like fun, frivolity, gaming. We use these words as a backbone of a life spent playing something. You use them as a punchline. I have neither the time nor the inclination to explain myself to a man who eats, smokes, and games under the blanket of the very frivolity I provide and then questions the manner in which I provide it. I would rather you just said thank you and went on your way. Otherwise, I suggest you pick up a microphone and start streaming. Either way, I don't give a damn what you think you are entitled to. Did you spy on the Discord? I did my job. Did you spy on the Discord? You're goddamn right I did.